Hello people of the internet, how's it going? So this video is about tips for new vegans and those who are veggie curious. It follows on from a video I made before, which I'll link just here. And to start off with, you're probably here, you know, your curiosity has made you click the link because one of three reasons. One, you think it's weird and unnecessary to hurt animals for food. Two, you want to improve your health. Or three, you want to improve your environmental footprint and improve the environment of our planet. All three of those are awesome reasons. And what happens with veganism is that all three of those are positively affected. I've created this term, stepping stones, and what it is it's kind of like a guide for people to go along. So if you're interested in sort of transitioning towards a vegan diet, these are the steps that I personally took and a few people I know have also taken. So it's just a guide, but if you feel that actually you want to skip out one of those guides and you're happy to do it overnight, then go for it. But my advice is that people take stepping stones. It's easier to achieve, and just kind of like the end goal is veganism. It's not like a race. It's, you know, once you're there, it's awesome, but it's not like you have to do it right this instant. If you've got three kids and you're not very good at change really quickly, then transition across the steps. Another thing to focus on is why you're doing it, because some people get put off because they start worrying about what other people are going to think about, you know, if I go vegetarian, people will think about this about me and they're going to treat me differently and stuff like that. What you need to focus on is all the positives that are happening because you're going vegetarian and I'm vegan, instead of the maybe thing that people will think. The other thing is to remember that people are going to think whatever they want to. You can't really have any control over it. Another thing to remember is a quote that Dorian Ryder passed on, which is, those that matter do not mind, and those that mind do not matter. And it's really a poignant point that, if you're doing something really positive and the people that matter, the ones that are going to support you and encourage you, the ones that are going to take the piss out of you and put you down because you're doing something positive. And for me, I just don't spend time with them and I just have less and less respect for them. And I sort of connect with the people that do support what I'm doing and do encourage me to do what makes me happy and what can make you guys happy as well. Some people get stressed out with food ideas. So they're like, oh no, now I've gone vegetarian or I'm going vegan, I've reduced what I can eat. There is basically a vegan version of everything out there. And then, so that's if you wanna go down the mock meat, the mock cheeses, the mock milk route, mock cream cheese, mock single cream, mock yogurts, that's fine. So there is a replacement, so you're not getting limited to choice, but I would suggest eating less processed foods, so like things like curries, homemade pastas, salads, couscous, buckwheat, rice dishes, risottos, those kind of things, and hummus as well. Hummus is a great thing to go to. It goes with like wraps and it goes with sandwiches and it goes with falafels. So there are options out there, and so you don't have to like think that you're being restricted on eating out, not going down on girls, but like eating out in restaurants and stuff. Eating out is vegan, just for the record, because you have consent from the other person. But back to food, basically eating out at restaurants or like where you can buy vegan food from, or vegetarian, is there's an app called Happy Cow. And what Happy Cow has is an international list of all the places that you can eat out and restaurants and what availability they have on their menu. And I would also suggest going to a Whole Foods shop. Whole Foods shops have lots of stuff that generally isn't in supermarkets, so lots of dry foods, mock vegan foods, different ideas, different seaweeds, all sorts of interesting things that you never really, I mean, I didn't even know existed. So like millet and kombu seaweed, and yeah, just go and try them out. The other thing about restaurants is that more and more restaurants, especially in the UK, are becoming having vegan options. But what you can do is just ring up. It takes a minute to ring the restaurant before and be like, what options do you have for a vegan, or can I veganize that certain meal? The thing is, those companies want your money. So if you see a goat's cheese salad, just say, can I have the goat's cheese not in it? Or if there's a burger that they've, like a veggie burger, but they use margarine on the bap, just say, can you not use margarine? It's just a couple of minutes. It's really easy to deal with that and allow you to eat vegan food in restaurants that you may not have thought of before. What I would suggest people to do is get yourself a blender so that you can make yourself some smoothies, you can blend up soups, you can make raw vegan cheesecakes. And what happens with a smoothie is you just get loads of nutrients in one big hit. Also, if you add fruits like strawberries, bananas and dates and raisins, you get a very sweet one. Or if you want to go down the route of more savory, you can put in things like spinach and kale and other green leafy vegetables. Some people put garlic and ginger in there. Each to their own. Find a recipe that works for you. And for me, it's bananas and strawberries at the moment. And another tip is don't leave the lid off your smoothie if you're going to turn the buttons on. I did it earlier and just sprayed smoothie all over my kitchen. It's actually all over my shorts. I'll show you now. Hopefully the focus works. If you can see, yeah, it's all the way across my shorts. My website is a resource for people to use, a free resource that I don't make any money from. But on there is lots of listings of different recipe sites and recommended videos. And one of them is the film Making the Connection. It is a really inspiring video made by the group Environmental Films, so please check it out. I'll put a link to it here. One thing that happens to people when they're transitioning their diets is they feel alone. If they come from a family that it is all meat eaters and they put down vegans and vegetarians, and then they become a vegetarian, can become quite alienating, and people question, like, well, you know, why am I the only one who thinks this compassionately? Why can't anybody else get it? So what I would do at that point is start connecting with the vegans and the vegetarians you know. So it's always cool to be around like-minded people, because you don't have to explain about, like, why you're not eating dairy or, you know, even little things. But it's just, you know, start connecting and being around like-minded people. If you're really stuck and you're really, like, you really don't know anybody else and you are the only vegan or vegetarian you know and you need a bit of support, get in contact with me however you like. You can either contact me on Facebook or send me an email, because yeah, it can feel lonely. I remember times when I was like, I'm the only one who thinks like this. And but I luckily had, you know, I do know a lot of vegans and vegetarian people. So for those who don't have that comfort, get in contact if you want. To start off with, my advice would be to change the food that you're eating. So if you're going vegetarian, start taking out meat and those kind of things. And if you're transitioning to vegan, start taking out those things. But all along the stepping stones, I would suggest that you start gradually taking out those things that are tested on animals and stop buying the things that are and stop using the things that are made with animal products, so like leather belts, leather wallets, and those kind of things. Within that, it is down to the individual what they want to do. Some people want to wear out their leather shoes, wear out their leather belts, and their leather wallets, and then when they've done that, they'll replace them with something that isn't made of animal products. Whereas others want to, they don't want to put the dead skin of somebody else on their body, so they choose to just collect all of their belongings, pass them on to a charity, pass them on to meat eaters, or even some people bury them. Ultimately, it is whatever works best for you. But I would suggest that you start with taking food out and then move along to, you know, like cosmetics and toothpastes and clothes after that. So overall, for those who are new vegans or who are veggie curious, you are awesome, open-minded people, and stay awesome, basically. Why you're awesome is because you have realized that it's unnecessary to stab animals for food. You want to improve your health, or you want to have a better impact on the environment. And veganism is the best lifestyle choice going. I say this because I've been thinking about it for a while, and all the others, so like you can be a philanthropist, you can be somebody who gives up all their money and then gives it away to charities and helps the homeless, all sorts of positive things. But if at the same time you are paying people to enslave, kill, torture, and ruin the lives of animals, then it's kind of counterproductive. All that positive you're doing on one side is being outweighed by the negative of your food choices. So why not do both? Why not be a vegan and a philanthropist for those that are interested? So that's why I believe that veganism is the best lifestyle choice, and it's awesome that you guys are interested in it. Again, my website is a free resource, so there's more information on there. And if you want some one-to-one help, or if you just want to connect with me, feel free to do that on Facebook or email. I hope you found this useful, and have a good day.